please write down relative velocity now. Relative velocity is a new concept. Relative velocity. What is relative velocity, anyone? What it is? Anyone?
Velocity of one body with respect to motion of another.
Okay, but if I say an object is going with 2 meter per second, what does it mean? Is that relative velocity?
Yeah, other bodies are friends.
Okay. Now, relative velocity, like she said, relative velocity is velocity of one object with respect to other object. Whenever you say that velocity is this much, see, when I say that velocity is, let's say, 2 meter per second, okay? Now somebody is calculating that velocity and generally telling you the velocity is 2 meter per second, yes or no? Somebody has calculated velocity is 2 meter per second and then telling you it is 2 meter per second. Are you getting it? Now, what will happen is that, suppose you have, this is the person who is telling you velocity of object is 2 meter per second. Okay? So, this is the object that is going with 2 meter per second. So, right now we will see that after every second, 2 meter distance is increased. So we'll be able to calculate, yes, velocity is 2 meter per second. Ready? Now let's say that this person itself, himself, is going forward with 2 meter per second. Then what velocity will observe? Zero. The distance between these two will not increase. Yes or no? So you feel that the object is at rest. Then if you ask this person, what is the velocity of the object? He will say it is zero. Understood? Okay. So whenever I say that velocity is 10 meter per second or 2 meter per second, without telling you who is calculating it, then you should assume that it is calculated by a person who is at rest. Okay. At rest means that with respect to Earth. Actually, Earth is also moving. Okay, but then since Earth is common across for all the living beings on the Earth, there might be life. So we can say that it is with respect to Earth. Whenever I say this is the velocity. Okay. Now at times what will happen is that the observer who is observing the velocity is moving. Then the observer will not be able to calculate the velocity with respect to Earth. Okay, achha, by the way, if velocity is with respect to Earth, we call it absolute velocity. Please write down. Velocity with respect to Earth or a stationary observer is the absolute velocity. Okay. And whenever you are given velocity, there is one observer who is observing the object and then telling you that this is the velocity. Alright? Now here, our observer is moving. For it, let's take one more example. Suppose this observer is moving with 5 meter per second. Then what velocity he'll find out for this object? I haven't told that plus is that direction, minus is that direction. Just tell me what the person will observe. The person will observe that the object is coming towards itself. Yes or no? Because distance between them is decreasing. Right? So absolute velocity of this object is forward. But relative velocity of this object is backwards. Okay? Alright? Now, when you are in a moving train, you might be seeing outside the trees are going backwards, right? Because you are observing, you are the observer, So relative to you, trees are moving backwards. Okay, so what you are doing essentially, whenever observer observes anything in this world, observer subtracts its own absolute velocity from everything he sees. For example, if you are in a moving train, you are going in this direction, you are observing a stationary tree, so you will subtract your velocity from the tree's velocity, which is zero. The zero minus your velocity is negative of your velocity. Okay, fine. Please write down, the observer observes. Observer will observe the world. Observer will observe the world by subtracting his or her own velocity. Clear? Okay. And in motion in 1D, you will not be dealing with vectors directly. Okay. But when we talk about relative velocity in two-dimensional thing, then also this statement which you have written is true. That observer will subtract its velocity, but that is vector subtraction. You cannot find, okay, you cannot say that I will subtract the absolute or you subtract the magnitude of the velocity. You have to have vector subtraction. For example, in motion 1D also, let's take one such example. Suppose this is the observer, this is the object. Observer is moving forward with 5 meter per second and the object is also moving with 5 meter per second. So can you tell me the velocity of B with respect to A? 10. Why not 0?
Minus sign.
Correct. You are considering it a vector when you say minus sign. Okay. So it is, if you are taking this direction positive, then velocity of observer is minus 5. So 5 minus of minus 5, which is 10. So that is positive direction 10, which is this way. Okay. So there is no exception to this rule, that you need to subtract the observer's velocity vectorially to find the relative velocity. Getting it? Now if this observer is moving this side 5 meter per second, then what is the relative velocity?
Zero.
Okay? All of you understood this, right? Now let me tell you another way to analyze the same situation. When it comes to motion in 1D, there is one very nice way to analyze the relative motion, which is, please first write down the relative motion. I am going to introduce the concept of approach and separation. Okay? You know the little meaning of it. So suppose this is object A and object B. A and B are there. Okay. Suppose they have to approach each other. So their velocity should be in the direction of each other. Yes or no? Simple. And let's take a respective example. Let's say this is V1, this is V2. So velocity of approach is? Velocity of approach is the velocity with which distance between them is decreasing, which is V1 plus V2. So that is V1 plus V2. Okay, suppose distance between them is D. D is the distance. So how much time will it take to come and meet? D divided by V1 plus V2. Okay. Velocity of approach is V1 plus V2. All other concepts of whatever you have learned till now, that distance will be speed into time and S equal to U2 plus half AT square, everything is valid in the relative scenario also. If you are able to find out relative acceleration, relative velocity, then you can use S equal to U2 plus half AT square if acceleration is constant. Getting it? It does not matter whether observer is moving or not moving. Let's see how. So in this case, velocity of approach is 0 plus V2. What is the velocity of separation? How much it is? Velocity of separation is what? Minus of V1 plus V2. Velocity of separation is negative of velocity of approach because they are opposite. If I tell you that 5 meter per second this side, so how much velocity that side? Minus 5. Simple. Right? So velocity of approach is V1 plus V2. Velocity of separation is minus of V1 plus V2. Clear? Now let's take this example. Suppose this is V1 and this is V2. How much is velocity of approach? V1 minus V2. Very simple, okay? V1 minus V2 is approach. V approach. Separation velocity? V2 minus V1. Okay, now can you tell me that if initial distance between them is d, if initial distance is d, how much time it will take for distance to increase to 2d? From d, the distance between them should increase to 2d. So how much time they should take? How much? Tell me. How much separation has happened? What is the amount of separation that has happened if it goes from D to 2D? D amount of separation has increased. With what velocity? V2 minus V1. So time is D divided by V2 minus V1. You can solve this by using absolute velocity also. But if you have this concept of relative velocity or approach clear, you can solve it in just one step. Okay? I'll show you a few more concepts where you'll see how easily you can solve with various questions using relative velocity. Is this clear? Now there is a concept of relative acceleration also. Okay, although in your school curriculum only relative velocity is there, but I am going one step forward where we are going to discuss relative acceleration also. Okay, which is same as velocity. Same. The way you deal with velocity of approach, similar way you deal with acceleration of approach also. Okay?